Chris Menard here. If you're a Windows 10 or a Windows 11 user, I have a great tip for you. Microsoft has a free utility called PowerToys. It has a lot of great features in it. Let's discuss how to get it, how to pull up and change keyboard shortcuts or figure out where these tools work at, and then let's look at three different ones. I'm going to pick on images today, so I'm going to do three of them regarding images. Here we go. First of all, how do you get PowerToys? You open up the Microsoft Store. After you open up the Microsoft Store, up in the search box, type in PowerToys. It is one word, and here it is over here. I've already installed it, so no need for me to install it again, but there you go. Also, it's got great reviews. 4.6 isn't too bad. Next is how do you pull it up and just look at it? You go to Start. Once you've installed it, type in Power, and there is PowerToys Preview. Click on it. Here are all the different features you have or modules you have in here. I'm only doing three today, and they're all image related. I'm going to do power rename. You can power rename, basically rename a bunch of images at one time. And this also works with other files besides images. We have the image resizer. This is specifically images. You've got a lot of large images. We'll resize those. And finally, the peak feature. It's got a keyboard shortcut, control space bar, and you'll see me use this, but if you don't like the keyboard shortcut, you click on peak one time, and here is where you change that keyboard shortcut from control space to something else. Image resizer and power rename, both of those are part of your right-click menu in File Explorer. Notice it says right-click context menu for both of those. You'll see these in File Explorer in just 1 second. Let's go ahead and use these three right now. I am in File Explorer. I have a bunch of images to start off with. Just to show you this, if I click on this first image, you could have the preview item located over there to the right. And if I double click it, it's going to open it up in my default image editor, which is normally okay. But I just want to see what these images are quickly. So control space bar, look how fast that launches. And the great news is you can either close this, but if you have a bunch of files, you can sit here and arrow through these images and take a peek at them right here. So that is control space bar with the peek feature. The other two image features were right click. Here's my example. These images I took with my mobile phone, they all came out starting with PXL. Let's say that these images are from a conference I attended, possibly a company retreat. This could be a vacation, whatever event that it is, I want the event name in these. So I'm going to select them all first and then right click. And as mentioned, there is resize and there is rename. These are both coming from PowerToys. Let's do the rename first. I've been in here playing. So it started off with PXL. They're the original images I've got selected. What do you want to call these? This was from a conference in Nashville. I'm just making this up. Nashville Conference 2026. You have other options down here. Right here in the middle of the screen, it's showing me the original file names, and then it's showing me what they're going to look like renamed. I like that you get this preview. I'm not going to cover it, but you even got a filter up here where you can do some other stuff. Let's just click on apply right now. Perfect. They got changed. Close this. Now it is easy to search for these files or images, because PXL, if that's the default name, is a horrible name. So I just renamed all the images. Watch this next feature. I'm going to sort by size quickly. If I need these for the intranet at my company or social media, these images, most of them are really way too large, except for this one that's 625 KB. I'm looking at the dimensions. By the way, if you're saying, Chris, how did you get dimensions to show? I right-clicked on size, I went to more, it was listed alphabetically, I found the word dimensions and checked it. So now I can see all the dimensions at one time in File Explorer. Some of these images are just way too large for social media. I mean, They would work, don't get me wrong, but they're just too large to post. So I want to resize them. I'm going to click on all of these except that one that's 625. That one's okay. What do you want the width to be? Instead of being 4,032, I'm making this up, I want them to be 1,600. So I'm going to right click. Let's go to resize with image resizer. You've got a bunch of defaults in here automatically. Feel free to use these if you want to, but I actually want to go and use custom. I'm going to put in the width of 1,600, and I actually had a height showing over here, and I got rid of the height with the X because I want them to stay in proportion. So if the width changes 50%, I want the height to change 50%. And ignore the orientation. When I hit resize, by the way, before I do this, I recommend you don't click overwrite files unless you truly want to do this, because I want to keep the original files that are really large, and I want a copy of these, so I'm making sure that's off. Hit resize, and I will get some copies, and there they are, and look, all those images that were 4,032 by 2,268 are 1,600 down here at the bottom. I did do the math, and they did stay in proportion, by the way, in case you're wondering about that. Now, back to that peak feature real quick. You're saying, Chris, the other features are great. I'm not sure about that peak feature. Peak feature also works with PDF files. I do not want to sit here and have to go launch Adobe Acrobat just to see if I want to open this file. So I can do the peak feature, and then from here, I could open this in Adobe Acrobat if that is the file that I want. Bonus tip, PowerToys, I use this one all the time. If you're sharing your screen, Zoom meeting, Teams meeting, I don't care what video conference platform you're using. If someone says, Chris, can you zoom in on the Excel file? Sure, I can hit the plus sign or the minus sign and zoom in and out. No big deal. But at some point, you're going to find yourself opening up dialog boxes. It is really hard to zoom in on a dialog box. Here's my example. If someone says, can you do some conditional formatting? And I say, sure, I need to go write a new rule. This is a dialog box. And if I go and do a formula and type something in here, someone say, I can't really see that formula. So part of PowerToys is the zoom it feature. I'm going to do control one on my keyboard, and I can now move the mouse around and pan around. And now everyone can see the formula that I typed in this dialog box. This is a great feature for trainers, but if you're sharing your screen and video conferencing all the time, this is at some point something you will need. Part of PowerToys, I'll have a whole session on Zoom It and other PowerToys features. Thank you for your time. My Teams training is available online, along with my Excel training, OneNote, and of course, Copilot. Have a great day.